Unfortunately, we know very little about the prevalence of dementia among most of the Asian American older adults, with the exception of Japanese Americans. One report by Lee and colleagues from the Memory and Aging Study of Koreans in Maryland found that in their sample of over 600 older Korean Americans recruited from the Korean churches in the Washington, D.C., and Baltimore area, 7% scored below the cutoff value for probable dementia on the Korean version of the MMSE-KC screening instrument. Several prevalence studies have been done in Korea, and the findings range from 7.4% to 13%.
Korean American caregivers. The exact profiles of Korean American dementia caregivers are not much known, although we can assume that family is still considered the main source of assistance and care to old adults in the Korean culture. There are few qualitative studies of Korean American caregivers in general, and I think those studies provide us with some insights about challenges and needs of Korean American caregivers, including dementia caregivers. In the previous section, Dr. Kwon covered changes in family systems and values, including gender roles, family relations, and filial responsibility. Because of those characteristics of life as immigrants, there are variations among Korean American caregivers about traditional norms toward elder care. For example, those who still strongly believe that children, or at least a family, should take care of their elderly parents, versus those who are open to utilize outside help. Although there are indications of values in transition, many caregivers at the same time expressed uneasiness about sending their care recipient to nursing home. The concept of nursing home is new to many Koreans, especially for elders, and it also conflicts with the long-standing tradition of respecting and caring for their aging family members. While they were ambivalent about using formal services and only thinking of it as a last resort, they expressed the needs for outside assistance with many caregiving activities. For example, many caregivers identified a lack of information about what to do or what not to do as one of the most important challenges, and they said that mostly they learned those tasks by themselves. Awareness about dementia care services. Korean Americans, both lay people and caregivers, showed extremely low awareness about dementia care-related services like respite care, dementia daycare center, Alzheimer's Association caregiver helpline, and caregiver support group. In research with the mainstream population, not knowing about available services is one of the main reasons dementia caregivers did not use services. Additionally, information about illness and resources and opportunity to talk with other caregivers are identified as the highest needs among dementia caregivers. Looking at the characteristics of these less-known services, we can know that they have the potential to satisfy caregivers' most unmet needs. In other words, there is a great need for raising community awareness about available services, and special outreach effort about available services would be beneficial for current and future dementia caregivers of Korean Americans. Having the background information just presented, we can think about how to accommodate Korean American caregivers' reluctance to use formal services and their pressing needs for outside help. We know that values are changing, but families still want to be the backbone of caregiving. At the same time, they need help. So, when discussing and promoting service use in dementia care with Korean American population, it would be appropriate to approach older clients and families without threatening family values and relationship. It would be also appropriate to address the fact that family care can continue to be the preferred option while using formal services, which can complement family caregiving and not substitute for it. It needs to be emphasized that formal services can assist caregivers to continue to support people at home, by giving caregivers a break and decreasing caregiving hours. Therefore, they can allow family to maintain filial responsibility by alleviating some pressure on them and eventually helping the family to continue to care for elders within the family in a higher quality manner. In the third section of this presentation, I'd like to talk about issues related to dementia when working with Korean American population, including selecting appropriate terms, beliefs, and knowledge about dementia. Findings I'm going to share in this section is from one of my research projects with Korean American population. Which term to use? Both in research and practice, the terms dementia and Alzheimer's disease are interchangeably used, and from time to time, I am asked by practitioners and other researchers about which term would be more appropriate, preferable, or recognizable in the Korean American population. Here, I can share some research findings which you can consider in choosing a right term for your own purpose and setting. This data is from a study of 209 middle-aged and older Korean Americans in Los Angeles area. Okay. It shows that 100% of study participants had heard of dementia compared to 82% had heard of Alzheimer's disease. Not surprisingly, older Korean Americans showed less awareness about the term Alzheimer's disease, which is 72%. In the same study, it was further asked whether dementia and Alzheimer's disease are same, different, one type of dementia, or don't know, and over a quarter of older participants reported that they don't know the answer. So it appears that Korean Americans were more familiar with dementia rather than the diagnostic label of Alzheimer's disease. Knowing this, you can use your discretion in selecting a term depending on purpose of choosing a term, your work setting, and serving population. For example, if you're working with general Korean American population, which is more of the preclinical stage, dementia may be more recognizable than Alzheimer's disease. When you are in a clinical setting, Alzheimer's disease would be a more correct way to describe the illness. In the next few slides, I'm going to talk about beliefs about dementia in Korean American population, including stigmatization, culture acceptance, and culture beliefs. I want you to keep in mind that I'm going to talk about these topics because they are related to barriers to timely diagnosis and treatment and using supportive social services in current and potential dementia situation. First, stigmatization of dementia as insanity. The majority of Korean American immigrants hold a strong stigmatizing view of dementia as insanity. As you can see in the slide, 75% believe so, and this rate is much higher than other racial ethnic groups like 40% of African Americans and 10% of white old adults believe that dementia is a form of insanity. The Asian culture norm of face saving considers exposing negative family events as shameful and embarrassing and avoid public disclosure of those events. Under this cultural influence and stigma attached to dementia, Korean American families may recognize signs of dementia in their relatives, but may not want to seek outside help in an attempt to avoid community awareness and stigmatization. This stigma of dementia and fear of public disclosure were reported as significant barriers of seeking evaluation and services in other Asian American dementia caregivers. Culture acceptance. Many Korean Americans considered memory loss to be a part of the aging process. For example, 84% believe that memory problems and associated behaviors are normal consequences of growing old. Although not majority, still 38% believe that dementia is a normal part of getting old. This view may stem from Asian culture norms that old age is a period of mental and physical deterioration, and memory problems are generally expected to occur. Under this cultural acceptance, many Korean American immigrants are likely to perceive memory loss, which can be signs of initial dementia symptoms, as natural and delay seeking medical evaluation until the disease reaches a later stage. Studies of Alzheimer's disease caregivers of other ethnic minorities support this possible phenomenon, and they reported that caregivers considered initial symptoms as normal and sought formal evaluation only after they encountered crisis events and functional disability. Social cultural causal attribution. As in the mainstream population, dementia can be explained from biomedical perspectives in Korean Americans. At the same time, non-biomedical explanation, which are more social cultural explanation, exist in Koreans. For example, 75% attributed dementia to physical and social inactivity when elders live alone, and 61% attributed dementia to introvert and passive personality. On a positive note, this is promising in that Korean Americans believing these attributions will presumably try to maintain more physically, mentally, and socially engaging lifestyle to prevent dementia. And their growing scientific evidence suggests that physical activity and social engagement may be beneficial to cognitive health. On a negative note, however, these attributions can result in blaming persons with dementia for bringing on the illness by not maintaining a stimulating living environment or having certain kinds of personality. Therefore, clinicians and providers of healthcare and social services who are generally trained in biomedical framework should also consider the social cultural aspect of dementia when working with Korean Americans. We can continue to promote physical, mental, and social activities. At the same time, we need to be aware of potential negative aspects of dementia attributions and incorporate it in our practice when necessary, so family members and patients are not engaged in unnecessary blame. Another interesting finding here in relation to social cultural attribution is that, similar to other Asian American caregivers like Chinese and Vietnamese caregivers, many Korean Americans interpreted dementia as a result of troubling life experience, such as emotional trauma and social relationship problems. Particularly, they identified Korean culture concept of Han as a cause of dementia. Han can be explained having unresolved personal, family conflicts, lifetime hardship, or issues that cannot be shared with others. These attributions can lead to stigma, shame, and embarrassment on the family, believing that dementia is a result of personal failure of those who had a negative family experience, personal experience. That can make them hesitate to disclose a condition to those outside the family. While respecting these cultural attributions, efforts need to be made to keep them from interfering with taking advantage of early diagnosis, available medication, and supportive services. Last thing I'd like to touch in relation to issues related to dementia in Korean American population is their knowledge about available treatment. Only 31% knew availability of medication to delay progression of dementia, and 43% knew medications to control behavior symptoms. At the same time, 64% correctly knew that there is no cure for dementia at present. In other words, sketch knowledge about dementia treatment combined with correct knowledge about cure can be another barrier to medical and social service use. Many Korean American immigrants might not feel a need to visit a doctor and receive a medical diagnosis even after detecting signs of dementia. So extensive efforts should be made in disseminating that even if the illness cannot be cured, the available medications for dementia along with early recognition can slow the deterioration process and enhance the well-being of persons with dementia and their caregivers.